Just a month after its global announcement, we finally got our hands on the new handheld gaming console, the ROG Ally. We're sure you have a lot of questions like how it compares to other handheld gaming consoles and whether or not you should buy one. So, let's dive in. Starting off with the design and construction of the ROG Ally. In terms of size, it's a bit bigger than the Nintendo Switch, but it is smaller than the Steam Deck. What I like about the ROG Ally is how thin and light it is. This makes it easy to carry in your backpack or even a shoulder bag. Unfortunately for you gents, it won't fit in a compact sling bag. Here's it next to a 32-ounce aqua flask for reference. In our opinion, it does look great in hand when in use. We do wish that it maybe might have come with a wrist strap so you don't accidentally drop it when you're carrying it around or playing on the go. Design-wise, the ROG Ally shares similarities with the Steam Deck and Nintendo Switch. You get two analog sticks positioned similarly to that of an Xbox controller with the D-pad located below the left analog. Compared to the slew of ROG devices out there that they've released in recent years, the ROG Ally kind of looks like the love child or what happens when you lock up a Zephyrus G14 and the ROG Phone 7 Ultimate in a bedroom. At the top, you get the power button and volume button, a USB-C port that doubles as the charger, and a microSD card slot for expandable storage, as well as a PCIe port to connect the ROG XG Mobile External GPU, the one meant for the ROG Flow lineup of devices. And this external GPU conveniently just connects to this proprietary port like so. And then you'd probably get a boost in graphical performance with this connected, which is neat. You'll also find the left and right bumper and trigger buttons here. There are also two extra buttons you can map located at the back. And noticeably, there are a lot of venting to help keep the device cool when gaming. Overall, the ROG Ally feels nice to hold and feels natural and comfy, kind of like handling somewhat of a big video game controller. Which means your hands won't get tired when playing for hours on end, but because of the Xbox-inspired layout, it may take a while for you guys to get used to it if you're more accustomed to a DualShock layout. At the center of the ROG Ally is the large 7-inch Full HD display. It also features a refresh rate of 120Hz, making it the best handheld gaming PC display currently in the market. And as a result, the games look stunning and smooth. Color reproduction is on the vivid end, making it more enticing to play and touch grass at the same time. It's also a touchscreen. There are even shortcut gestures that you can get used to within a few hours. It's quite bright too, making it easy enough to game when outdoors, but probably not the best when under direct sunlight. In fact, we recently took this very ROG Ally with us on a beach trip, and it was easy to use despite the harsh sun. That goes for whether you're playing, watching videos, or just surfing the net. The speakers on this thing are also pretty great, but there's also a headphone jack right here if you want a more immersive audio experience. And yes, you heard us right. You can actually watch YouTube, Netflix, and even surf and do whatever you would do on a Windows laptop on the ROG Ally because it runs on Windows, specifically Windows 11 Home. Powering the ROG Ally is an AMD Zen 4-based Ryzen 7 Z1 Extreme CPU. It's basically a gaming laptop that ditches a keyboard for controller buttons. Our unit came with 16GB of RAM and 512GB of internal storage, but if that's not enough, there is a microSD card slot to expand storage of up to 1TB. So you can think of the ROG Ally as more than just a handheld gaming console. Like I said, it can also be a much more portable gaming laptop, but without the hassle of having to set it up and whatnot. Technically, you can install almost any app or game into the ROG Ally, the same way you would on a Windows PC or laptop. We've installed Lightroom on the ROG Ally and it works, although you will have to contend with editing your photos on a smaller 7-inch screen. You could, however, connect a monitor, keyboard, and mouse if you wanted to play more competitive titles like CSGO, Valorant, Call of Duty, and other competitive FPSs out there. Of course, titles like Genshin and Star Rail were not an issue with the ROG Ally either, but we were surprised that it couldn't run Star Rail smoothly with the graphics settings maxed out. That said, you might have to tweak the settings if you're playing graphic-intensive titles. Still, not that bad considering that the device didn't seem to uncomfortably heat up. Navigating through the Windows desktop using the analog sticks can kind of be a hassle, but here's a quick tip. Make sure to increase your cursor speed in your Windows settings. In addition to Windows, ASUS also did a great job integrating their Armory Crate. They've even dedicated two buttons that are mapped for Armory Crate for better ease of use with the Ally. One of them gives easy access to a menu that allows the user to change performance level, brightness, and even the navigation mode. No need to stop playing and go through the settings manually. Meanwhile, the other one opens up your game menu, which features your whole library of games installed on the ROG Ally, from your Steam library down to your Battle.net and even Xbox Game Pass. You can choose your games very quickly and easily through this menu. Like a laptop, you can click the power button on the ROG Ally and the device will enter sleep mode. However, we notice that the game is only minimized and isn't exactly paused or suspended. As a result, you can still hear the background music or stuff happening, and this can drain the battery quite fast, which is another topic we will touch up on. Before that, let's check out the benchmark scores of the ROG Ally, flashing them on screen now! One of the weaker links of the ROG Ally is the battery. When you're gaming, the battery drains rather quickly, so you might want to sit near a power outlet or bring a big power bank when you plan to game with the ROG Ally on a beach or something. We were playing Honkai Star Rail in high settings and on turbo mode, max volume, max brightness, and at 120Hz. After just 1 hour, the battery drained from 100% to 40%, which is extremely limiting for a portable gaming console. Interestingly, the battery on the ROG Ally lasted better when we ran our video loop test on Windows mode. It was able to last 9 hours and 52 minutes in comparison to when we were playing games. As for the price, as of recording this video, ASUS has yet to release the local price for the ROG Ally here in the Philippines. For reference, it starts at $699 in the US, which is roughly 39,000 pesos. My guess is it'll be sold here for around 40 to 50 to 60K. We will pin the official SRP in the comments once it's out. So what's our verdict on the ROG Ally? It's definitely a great handheld gaming console that doubles as a workstation if you need it to be. You can run almost any game provided you adjust the graphic settings beforehand. And at the same time, you can even do anything else you would on the standard Windows PC or laptop. The only downside we could think of at the moment is that short battery life when you're playing, so you'll either find yourself plugged into an outlet or carrying a power bank all the time. But that begs the question, is the ROG Ally for you? Because if you want a game on the go and have the convenience of using a Windows OS, then the ROG Ally is perfect for you. But if you prefer playing games that require a mouse and keyboard, then you might be better off with a gaming laptop. Alternatively, maybe you want to dive into PC gaming when you've solely been an Apple user for your whole life. This could be the perfect device for you. At the end of the day, it all depends on what you want and what you need. So yeah, that was the ROG Ally. Let us know what you guys think of this device in the comment section below. And if you found this video enjoyable, informative, or educational, be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and hit that bell icon so you get notified of our future uploads. Be sure to visit yugatech.com for the latest tech news and reviews. Again, this has been Miguel, and this has been the ROG Ally. And we will see you, or I will see you, in the next one.